Welcome back. In today's lecture, again I am going to talk about some basic idea from the calculus only, and today's topic is constraint minimization of functions. In next lecture, I am going to actually extend same kind of things, and here I am going to talk about constraint minimization of functional in a space of functions. Or functional is nothing but functions of function we have already seen, and that map back to some kind of real number, so a scalar, some kind of things. So let us try to see the problem. Till now, whatever we have learned, that so far what we have seen, that I have some kind of functional, and here in this particular functional, this particular xt is actually some kind of column vector, x dot is column vector. We are assuming that each entry of this column vector is independent, and then we have to find the necessary condition for the extremal. So I am going to write the assumptions. So what we found, that these two assumptions are required in order to solve the above class of variational problem. We are assuming that x and g satisfy the continuity and differentiability requirement, because in order to talk about the variation, we have to talk about the increment, and during increment these two things comes into picture. And after that, we are also assuming that component of x are independent, so somehow there is no constraint on the entry of this particular functional. So here you can see entry of x and x dot, so there is no constraint. We are assuming all are independent, but let us try to see the control problem. So whenever we are talking about the optimal control problem, so somehow I have to track on the output. And suppose in some particular problem we are assuming that all states are available as a output. So basically what happens now, that I have to track on this xt, and now whenever optimization is involved, then we have certain kind of specific functional, and minimization or maximization of that functional, we are talking about the futuristic behavior of this xt. And if you see this class of problem, so here I have some system, so differential equation is given to us, and after that I have initial condition. Now u is the some kind of choice which depending on the xt or explicit value of t. So what we are assuming, that u I can choose based on our specification, so we can choose anything. And after that, what kind of basically problem comes into picture, you can see that what I have written, in control problems the situation is more complicated. The state trajectory is determined. State trajectory means whatever future output we are talking about, by the control u, and thus we wish to consider functional of n plus m functional. Here in this particular problem, we are assuming that basically x belongs to Rn and u belongs to Rm. So I have n number of state variable, m number of control input, and due to that reason I have to define functional, that is function of xt as well as u. So basically total I have n plus m variable. Out of this m plus n variable, m of functional are independent, so control is only independent. So I can choose control, but I cannot tell that I can actually choose xt. Only one thing I can choose, that is control. And due to that reason, you can see that functional is basically containing n plus m functions. Out of that, only m number of function is independent. So Now, each entry of functional is not independent. Somehow, only m entry are independent. And in that situation, you have to solve the, again, optimization problem related to optimization. So due to that reason, we are telling this is optimal control problem. It means that we have certain specification. We have to find the admissible control input, admissible trajectory. These kind of things comes into picture. So I have written the aim of today's lecture to extend the necessary conditions we have derived to include problem with constraint. So far I am not talking about any constraint. Whenever I am talking about problem on calculus of variations, in today's lecture I am not going to talk about calculus of variation. First we are going to see that whenever I have to minimize some function, and at that time whenever constraint comes into picture, then how to tackle that constraint. Once we understood this concept, then I will extend same kind of things whenever functional comes into picture. So it is very easy to picturize if you understood the problem of calculus, and after that you can extend it for calculus of variation. So let us start with example. So I have taken very simple example. During 10 plus 2, you have already seen this kind of example. So basically I have two dimensional plane. I have represented that plane by y1 and y2. So what I am telling, in two dimensional plane I have certain line that is represented by y1 plus y2 equal to 5. Now I have to find the point on this particular line that is nearest to the origin. And you all are well aware that whenever we have to find nearest point, then we are actually putting projection from here to this particular line, and based on that projection I can able to find the length of this, because somehow I have to find length as well as I have to find this particular point. So by simple geometry I can able to just able to see that basically this point is nothing but 5 by this length is 5 by root 2 and this point is 2.5. So from this simple elementary plane geometry one can able to do this. So this is solution by inspection. But most of time, even if you are talking about classical calculus, problem with constraint is not so easy. So due to that reason, we have in calculus several methods are actually proposed by the people, and most useful methods, that is called elimination method or direct method, and second one is called Lagrangian multiplier method. So I will tackle method one by one. So let us start the elimination method. So I am going to solve same problem using the elimination method. This is also called the direct method. So in some literature this is known as direct method. So let us try to see that how to apply direct method to the same problem. So suppose if y star is the extremal point of the function, then we know that necessary condition that differential of the function evaluated at y star to be 0. What we are assuming, that I am only going to talk about the maxima inside the interval. We are not going to talk about the boundary point. Otherwise what happens, it might possible extremal point might lie on boundary also. But we are assuming that basically extrema lie inside some interval or some region. So suppose I have certain kind of function. You can see this is my function ft. So we are just going to talk about this particular time, and here we are not including the boundary point, and in that particular boundary particular interval we are going to talk about the extremal value of function. So necessary condition is the differential of the function that is evaluated at y star, that should be 0. Suppose I have some function like this, or I have certain function like this, something like this I am assuming. So you are able to understand, means this is from the classical calculus. So you are able to understand that here I have minima, here I have maxima. So differential at this particular point y star, that should be zero. You might also learn that whenever this boundary condition is included, then you have to see the boundary point also. So we are assuming for simplicity that boundary is not included here. Now you can see that distance, whenever you are calculating distance of any point, suppose that I have this line and I am going to calculate distance of any point of line from the origin, then you can see that is given by y1 square plus y2 square and square root of this. And due to that reason, for simplicity, I am going to calculate the square of distance. So whenever I have to calculate the length, at that time I am going to take the square root of f y1 y2. Now what we have to do, that distance of any point, if you take any point from origin is given like this, but I have certain kind of constraint. How to interpret constraint? We are assuming that particularly that whenever we are talking about distance from the origin to this particular line, that should be minimum. So that is the constraint now I have. So now you can see that if I know y1, then I can calculate y2, and due to that reason we are telling that y1 and y2 is not independent, that is depending. If you are able to fix one, another is automatically fixed. And here, suppose if you have this kind of function, then differential of this function, if y1 star y2 star is the minimum, so derivative or the differential equal to zero. And due to that reason, first we have to calculate the differential. So let us try to see that what is differential. So dou f by dou 1 y1 y2 and delta y1 increment in this direction, and similarly increment in y2 direction. And here we have to calculate partial derivative with respect to y2. And I have already told you that whenever we are talking about extremal point, at that time I have to equate this equal to zero. So we are already well aware about this particular fact. Most of time during 10 plus 2 we have function with only one variable. At this time we have function with two variable, and due to that reason partial derivative comes into picture. First I have to calculate partial derivative of function with respect to y, and I have to take increment in direction of y. Similarly, I have to calculate the partial derivative with respect to y2 and take the increment in direction of y2, and after that this equal to zero. Now if you see the problem, means whenever I am talking about the calculus of variation, at that time we are assuming that this y1 and y2 is independent. Due to that reason, increment of delta y1 and delta y2 are independent and arbitrary. But here that is not the case, because somehow we have to find some point on the line only, and due to that reason I cannot assume that delta 1 y1 and delta 2 are arbitrary or independent. And due to that reason, what we have to do, we have to actually, one cannot process in the same way. Same kind of things basically I have written here. If y1 and y2 were independent, we have already assumed this in last four lectures, then delta 1 y1 and delta y2 could be selected arbitrarily. Anything you can select. And finally I have to put this differential equal to zero, or means we are talking about variation equal to zero. At that time, since these two are arbitrary, so in order to calculate the necessary condition, I have to substitute this equal to zero and this equal to zero. But this is not the case whenever we have some kind of constraint. So same kind of things I have written here, that however y1 and y2 are constrained to be lie on the specified line, and so delta y1 and delta y2 are not independent. Somehow they are depending, and due to that reason I have to formulate some relation either in terms of delta y1 or delta y2. So you can see that relation of delta y2 in terms of relation of this function in terms of y2, then in place of y1 I have to substitute equation in terms of constraint. So I know that y1 plus y2 equal to 5, and due to that reason in place of y1 I have substituted 5 minus y2, and here y2 square. So, and if you solve this algebraic equation, then we will get this particular, this is somehow I have now some kind of quadratic equation that comes into picture. 2y2 square minus 10y2 and plus 25 equal to some function, that is function of y2. And now I can assume that delta y2 is arbitrary, because finally what happens that whatever function I have considered here, now that is function of just one independent variable, and due to that reason I can assume that that variable is independent. So what basically we are doing, whenever some function is given to me, using the constraint condition I am going to express whole things in terms of independent function. Either since here two variables are involved, y1 and y2, and due to that reason either I can express function in terms of y1 or y2, and after that I have to again apply the necessary condition that differential of f at some point y2 dash y2 star, or whenever we are talking about function in terms of y1, then y1 star that equal to 0. So same kind of things I have done here, and if you calculate the dou f by dou y2, you can see that here minus 10 comes into picture, 2 and 2 that is 4, and y2 star and delta y2, and this equal to 0. Since this is arbitrary, due to that reason this should be coefficient should be 0 in order to satisfy the necessary condition, and due to that reason in this way I can able to calculate the y2 star. And once I know the y2 star, I know that y1 star plus y2 star that equal to 5, and due to that reason I am also able to calculate what is my y1 star. And once you calculate the y1 star and y2 star, so basically now you are able to understand the this point about this point. This point is 2.5 and 2.5. Then now you have to just, what you have to do, you have to, in order to calculate the minimum length, you have to just see the distance from here to here. And if you calculate that distance, basically that distance is nothing but 5 by root 2. So in this way you are able to solve constraint minimization problem. Basically here I have taken, similarly you are able to talk about the maximization problem of some function. Now let us try to see another method, and after the completion of lecture you are able to understand that this particular method, the Lagrangian multiplier method, that is much simpler than elimination method whenever order of problem is very large. So basically in this particular method, what we are going to do, whenever we have some kind of function, we are going to define some kind of argumented function, and basically argumented function is nothing but some kind of function, and this function is basically, if you see carefully, then this particular function is nothing but constraint. So your constraint is y1 plus y2 equal to 5. So you have to define some kind of relation y1 plus y2 minus 5. So you can see that if constraint is satisfied, then automatically this term p multiplied with this term that equal to 0, and finally maximization and minimization problem is reduced back to original maximization or minimization problem. and due to that reason, this particular way gives same result as we are expecting from the elimination method. So idea is pretty simple. Whatever constraint that is given, equality constraint, so you have to write constraint in such a way such that at the point of extremum, this should be zero. If this should be zero, then what happens? That you can select any arbitrary p, but maximization or minimization problem is actually reduced back to original maximization or minimization problem. If you see the original problem, then I have to minimize f, that is function of y1, y2, that is y1 square plus y2 square. So once constraint is satisfied, you can see that I come back to the same problem. Now what happens that in this particular problem, p is some kind of arbitrary variable that is also known as Lagrangian multiplier, and I hope that this particular work is actually given by Lagrangian, and due to that reason, in the honor of his name, basically we are telling this method as a Lagrangian multiplier method. And basically now what we have to do, I am going to find the extremal point of the argumented function, not the original function. Now we have defined the argumented function, and after that we have to find the extremal point of the argumented function, and again necessary condition remains the same. What we have to prove that differential at the point of extrema, y1 star y2 square y2 star that equal to 0. And if you calculate again the differential, then you can see that I have increment in delta y, and this is dou fa by dou y1. Similarly, dou this is dou fa by dou y2, and basically due to that reason here y1, so here y2 is here multiplied by delta y2, and after that I have to calculate the partial derivative with respect to delta p, and due to that reason you can see that partial derivative of this argumented function with respect to y, so this is 0, this is 0, so finally y1 plus y2 minus 5, so same kind of equation of constraint basically comes into picture, same kind of things, because now in last I have to somehow, I am going to, by fixing p, I can argue that everything become independent. So coefficient of this equal to 0, this equal to 0, this equal to 0. So this is the one of the way, but we have to understand systematically why I am telling that coefficient of each delta y1, delta y2 and delta p equal to 0, because we are knowing that y1 and y2 is dependent. Still we are telling same kind of thing. So we have to actually clarify the logic behind that. So let us try to understand this. So what we are telling, since only point that satisfy the constraint relation, that should be satisfy this kind of relation, and due to that reason this is zero, so I can tell that this may be any arbitrary value. So same kind of things is written here. The remaining two term must add to 0, but delta y1 and delta 2 are not independent, I have already told you. So if delta y1 is selected, delta y2 is determined, and vice versa. Now but what happens, and this kind of things we have done during the elimination method or direct method, that we are expressing function in terms of y1 and y2, and after that we are going to take the increment, because both are not independent, both are depending on each other, and due to that reason I am going to talk take some kind of convenient choice, because now I have one more variable to rescue, and that is p variable. So try to see that we select p so that coefficient of delta y2 or delta y1, so either you can select for the coefficient of delta y2 or delta y1, that should be 0, and In that way, I can calculate the value of P and I am going to give that name as a P star. So basically, if you see that again, the differential of this argumented function, so I am going to suppose if I am going to make coefficient of this equal to 0. So basically, in that way, I have fixed that P star. And finally, if this is 0, this is already 0, so I have only one choice, this should be 0. And same kind of things I have written here, that after that, what happens, since DFA must be 0 and delta y1 is arbitrary, then coefficient of delta y1 must be 0. So finally, what happens, we are selecting one choice and after that I have no option, and finally what happens, that this kind of equation comes into picture. And in order to calculate the extremal point, now you have to solve three different algebraic equation. So either you can express in matrix form or any other convenient form, and you can calculate the value of y1, y2, and one more the variable that comes into picture, because you have argumented the function, and due to that reason, some more variable comes into picture. So somehow this variable is acts like catalyst, and in that way, what happens, solution of problem become little bit easy. And you can able to observe this kind of situation when I am going to talk about the general problem. So far I have just considered that function with two variables. Now suppose that I have function with n plus m variable, and out of n plus m variable, suppose m variable is independent. So basically I have n number of constraint. So in general case, what we are assuming, that my function is only of two variable, and out of two variable, what happens, that we have some kind of relation between those two variable. Here what I am assuming, that so in previous problem I have just one independent variable. Now what I am going to define, that I have function and I have to basically extremize that function that contain n plus m number of variables, and out of n plus m variable, just m variable are independent. It means that n constraint we have, and constraint I have expressed like this. So based on the problem, I have different function, and I have to equate all function equal to 0. And in that way, I have calculated based on the constraint, we are able to understand that how many independent variable, total number of variable minus constraint equal to independent variable. And after that, what we have to do, that somehow I have to express this particular, whenever we are going to apply the elimination method or direct method, since y1 up to y plus n plus m, that is actually I have m number of independent variable. Due to that reason, we have to do certain kind of arrangement, and after that we have to express that constraint using that n variable, and due to that reason I have telling that okay, this kind of choice basically comes into picture whenever we are going to do some kind of substitution. So once we will see the problem, then we are able to understand this. This is pretty easy step. And after that, now you can see that what I have to do, I have to again calculate the, now I have some kind of function, and inside the function I have m number of independent variable, and whenever I have independent variable, then problem again reduce back to classical problem. You have to calculate differential, and after that you have to put dou f by dou x into delta y1, dou f by dou y2 by delta y2, similar like that, and after that their increment might be arbitrary, due to that reason coefficient equal to 0. So same kind of things you have to do, and after that you have to solve the extremization problem. So this is the necessary condition, and after that, after calculating y1 plus yn plus 1 star, yn plus m star, you have to also evaluate other variable, because this is just for an independent variable, and based on independent variable you are able to define the dependent variable. So in this way we are applying the elimination method. You can see that here a step is not so easy, because everywhere you have to do adjustment and you have to express things in n variable form. This step is also not easy, and after that, after getting y1 plus 1, yn plus m, again this step is also not easy. Let us try to see the another method that is called Lagrangian multiplier method. And in Lagrangian multiplier method, now suppose you have n number of dependent variable. So basically you have just m number of independent variable. So what you can do, you can define some kind of argumented variable and their number is n, because you have total number of variable is n plus m, and out of n plus m variable you have n number of constraints, so m number of variable is independent. So based on constraint you have to select the number of the argumented variable, and based on that variable now what you can do, you can define the argumented function, and again in order to apply the same formulation, what you can do, you can take the differential, and after taking the differential now I have to again argue in same way, because you can see that a1 an whatever dou here, dou f by dou p1 and delta p1 that comes into picture. So this should be satisfied, and due to that reason means delta p1 is arbitrary, delta pn is arbitrary, due to that reason coefficient is also zero. So in summary I can tell that just I have to equate this equal to zero, this equal to zero, and after that a1 equal to zero and an equal to zero. In this way things become pretty easy. So the constraint are satisfied, then coefficient of this equal to zero. So I have already told you that we have select np so that coefficient of delta yi are zero. Similarly, whenever we are solving second order problem, then what basically we are doing, we are fixing one, so automatically second will fix. And similar kind of things here I have to do, that remaining m delta y are independent, so df to equal to zero and their coefficient must be vanish. If you fix the n number of p's, then automatically all are independent, and finally same method whatever we have learned you can apply. So in summary what we have to do, this is the constraint equation at the extremal point, and after that you have to calculate dou f by dou yj for argumented equation, and this particular equation just you have to solve 2n plus m number of equation. So in that way I am able to solve the extremization problem. So this is the necessary condition. Try to see same problem by one kind of example, because sometime whenever we are developing theory, then at that time it is little bit difficult to picture. So what I am assuming, that I have certain kind of three dimensional Euclidean space. So I have this space and I have y1, y2 and after that y3, and in this space what happens, I have certain kind of surface. You can see that equation of this surface is given like this and this, and what we have to find, whenever these two surfaces is going to intersect, we have to find the distance of their intersection point. Suppose this is the intersection point of these two plane, then we have to find the distance from here to here that is nearest. So we have to minimize the function, so somehow I have to minimize this distance, and after that these two are constrained. So basically if you see the function, then function square of distance, again I am going to take, that is y1 square, y2 square and y3 square. And in terms of Lagrangian multiplier, you can see that I have basically two plane, and due to that region I have two constraint. So three dimensional space and with two constraint it means that I have just one independent variable, and number of Lagrange multiplier is 2, and due to that reason I have selected p1 and p2, and due to that reason I have selected p1 and p2, and I have actually retained these terms such that if I calculate the partial derivative with respect to p1, that remains 0. It means that once I calculate the extremal point, at that time my argumented function and original function both equal to remains the same, because I cannot going to change my optimization problem or extremization problem. I am going to extremize same function, and due to that reason, whenever I will get extremal value, at that time you have to show that your original function and whatever function you have actually formulated, that should be exactly same. So that is the actually crux of the matter. And now you can see that now these two equation is coming from the constraint, because dou f a by dou p1, if you calculate, then this equal to 0. And only a star point means we are talking about extremization problem. And similarly, this algebraic equation comes into picture. Now basically you can see that these three equation, that is due to dou f a by dou y1. So with y1 I have 2y1, and here from p1 y2, and now since we are talking about extremal point, so p1 and p2 is also has some specific value, and due to that reason p1 star and p2 star also comes into picture. And in this way I have three different equation, that is dou f by dou y1, dou f by dou y2, dou f by dou y3, and coefficient of that should be 0, because increment is basically arbitrary. Now solving this, I can able to find the extremal point, and once you are able to find the extremal point, then you are able to find the minimal value. And we have actually taken, that is a square of that, due to that reason I have to calculate the square root of that. So in today's lecture, what we have seen, that suppose if there is no constraint and I have to calculate the maxima and minima, then things are pretty easy. You have to calculate the derivative at that point, and you have to take derivative equal to 0. Now if you have constraint, then what happens? Because whenever you are calculating the derivative of something, and if function contain more than one independent or dependent variable, then you have to calculate partial derivative with respect to each and every variable. And if their increment are not independent, then I cannot assume that independently their coefficient equal to 0. So somehow they are depending, and due to that reason I have to either reduce the order of my problem, and such that number of independent variable and number of increment we are telling, that will match, and in that way, so that is called elimination method. Another way, I am going to argument the function, and after argumenting, what happens? Now I have choice of the argument variable, and that will act like catalyst. And what happens, once I will get the maximum or minimum point, extremal point, then argumented function and that function become equal, and in that argumented function now I can apply the classical way, you can tell, whatever way we are handling the unconstrained case. So same kind of basically case comes into picture. So now in next class I am going to extend this result of calculus to solve the variational problem with some kind of constraint. So constraint minimization or maximization of the variational problem, and that is actually our actual problem. So in next class, first I will tackle that, and after that I will going to talk about the optimal control problem. So thank you very much.